Today we are going to discuss about the last type of osteosarcoma, which is the telangiectatic type of osteosarcoma. Be sure to check out my previous videos regarding the classic intramedullary type of osteosarcoma and also the periosteal and periosteal type of osteosarcoma. Well, for the last type, I put it on the last type because it's quite different and it's quite easy for one to differentiate this type of osteosarcoma once you get used to the details. For basically, these type of tumor occur in a quite rare manner as compared to the ones at the classic type, and generally it is found more common in male as opposed to female. But for the location, what makes it interesting is that the location of this telangiectatic type of tumor is similar to those found in an ABC. For those who have no clue about what is ABC, ABC is basically aneurysmal bone cyst. It's a mnemonic for it. And so the location of this type of tumor is generally found in the proximal humerus, proximal femur, distal femur, or proximal tibia. The etiological factor is very similar to osteosarcoma, the classic type. This I'm going to show it once again to you. So these are the subtypes of patient where you could see an increased risk of developing this classic or telangiectatic type of osteosarcoma. The ones with the retinoblastoma tumor suppressor gene abnormalities, the one with Rodman-Thompson syndrome, and the ones with P53 or Li-Fraumeni syndrome. Okay, and we go back to our topic today. So telangiectatic osteosarcoma is basically a malignant osteogenic tumor with certain risk factors such as prior radiation. Now, what makes it different is that even though pain is commonly seen in most types of tumors, you could find that these patient subtypes of patients have pathologic fracture. Now, the thing about osteosarcoma is that it is a bone-forming tumor, and generally when you think of bone, you think that, okay, this patient has more bone than what normal human would have. But you need to know that the bones that are deposited, the bones that are formed by these tumor cells, they are not a normal bone. So these types of bones, even though there are loads of them, the amount of bone has increased indeed, these types are not normal stress-oriented bones. And therefore, sometimes in these types of patients, you could see fracture. But what makes patients with telangiectatic types of osteosarcoma, they have a higher tendency of developing pathologic fracture? Well, I'll explain that in a little bit. So first we move on to the physical findings. You can see that there's local swelling, tenderness, the usual stuff. But for the plain radiograph, this is where it gets interesting. You could see here that the discovery of the lesion is in a lytic stage. You could, if you remember, that generally osteosarcoma lesion is blastic, even though some are mixed with lytic lesions, but generally they are blastic. Therefore, the basic nature of the lesion itself is actually bone forming instead of bone destroying. And you could see here that in this subtype of osteosarcoma, you could see that there is a destructive expansal lesion, and even the entire cortex can be compromised. And these are one of the reasons why you would find pathologic fracture more frequently compared to the other subtypes. And next we move on to bone scan, which is usually revealing a hot lesion, as you can see here. And for the MRI, it's the usual. But once again, MRI is not only to detect the presence of neurovascular bundle involvement in tumor cases, but in telangiectatic type, remember the word angiect because it is sort of vascular kind of tumor, and therefore you could see the amount of fluid collection there, and the borders between the blood and also the other serous fluids forming around the tumor will give you a image that is a fluid level. It's like an egg cut in half. If you see the MRI lesions, I'm not sure if you can see it clearly. You could see it here. You could see here that there's a very clear fluid level. These are both fluids, but they have different densities, and therefore they have different image quality seen on MRI, but you could see it clearly that it is two types of fluid, and these types of images are very associated with this subtype of osteosarcoma. Well, for the mitotic figures, because these are generally associated with blood, remember angio is blood, so vascular, so you could see here that there is mitotic figures but also lakes of blood in your histological specimens. But what makes it different is that you could also see malignant cells within those lakes of blood, and that makes it very different from the ones in the ABC, which normally you would not find any malignant cells in ABC. Well, histologically, you could not as much see osteoid as the ones in the classic osteosarcoma. And for the gross pathology, one would say that you could find a bag of blood, which basically just means that it is a very bloody tumor. And for the ABC, as the differential diagnosis, you could say that they have a very similar radiograph with also similar large blood filled space, and the location of the lesion is also quite similar to the ones in the teleangiectatic type. You could see here a table that puts together very nicely, starting from the epidemiology, radiographs, MRI, and also histology. You could see here that ABC usually have blood filled spaces, but note this, they have no evidence of malignant cells on the pathological report. While on the teleangiectatic type, you would see malignant cells with mitotic bodies. Now that you have know all the basics under diagnosis, here comes the management. Once again, tumors need to be operated. You cannot live together with them. They are like parasites sucking your life source and just killing you by the minute. And operation is usually by multi-agent or neoadjuvant chemotherapy regimen that is followed by limb salvage resection. And limb salvage is usually reserved for certain criteria, certain conditions only, where the lesion is resectable, leaving the remaining body region clear of tumor cells that is producing a tumor clearance similar to amputation. You should not see any neurovascular involvement there, and it is also indicated as a standard treatment. For more information regarding the principles of limb salvage, be sure to check out my oncology basics video, which is in the oncology playlist. Next, the technique for the treatment. You could see that for the pre-op chemotherapy, it is generally being given for 8 to 12 weeks, which drugs may include doxorubicin, cisplatin, methotrexate, the regular ones, followed by post-op chemo. And for the post-management, you could observe the patient for any signs of local recurrences, which the rate is as high as 5%. You could also see that in local recurrences, generally the patient has a poor prognosis, and they usually have recurrences if there is a previous pathological fracture. As for the prognosis, generally these type of tumor, they have the same prognosis such as osteosarcoma, and survival is also the same as the classic type, but generally these types of patient is more chemosensitive. The 5-year survival rate in localized tumor is up to 70%, and the ones in the populations with metastasis is generally only as low as 20%, unfortunately. Well, I guess that is all for today's discussion regarding teleangiectatic osteosarcoma. If you'd like to see more videos regarding osteosarcoma, be sure to check out my channel, and don't forget to subscribe to Orthopedic Tumor for more videos. Thank you.